Hey guys, what is up, the NeoCubest here? Welcome to episode 19 of my hardcore survival let's play. So this weekend truly has been an exciting one. We've done a ton of awesome stuff. We found our first village. We've made a 3,000 plus slime ball per hour slime farm. So go check out episode 16 of my hardcore survival let's play if you missed it. They're all on a big playlist, so you can find them there over there on the right. But yeah, go back and watch episode 16. We make a 3,000 plus slime ball an hour slime farm. You can see where we sit to AFK for the farm over there. But if you guys notice you're not subscribed, only 30% of people who watch my channel are subscribed. So if you're part of that 70% and you notice that you're watching me, you should subscribe if you want to. If you don't want to, that's okay too, but consider subscribing. I would really appreciate it. Okay, so in this episode, I plan to build a giant railroad. And when I say giant, I mean absolutely massive, over 1,000 blocks. Now, of course, I'm not going to record all of it. I'll record the exciting parts, or most of them. And, not too exciting to build a railroad, so I won't film a ton of it. But look at all the iron we got. Hopefully that's enough. If it's not enough, that's okay too. But we're at least going to try. We're going to try. So let me clean up this inventory a little bit, and then I'll get back to you, and we're going to try to craft all the rails we're going to need. All right, so I got my inventory all cleaned up here. We're going to try to craft some railroads off the bat. We're going to need to make a bunch more sticks, but okay. Well, I just did what I said I wouldn't do because I didn't want to run out of inventory space. So now we'll just do this. We'll just shift click. Boom. Wow. Okay, so maybe, maybe I made too many here. Can this be in a stack? Sure. That's fine. Wow, okay, maybe I did make too many. Okay, let me count those out real quick. I'm actually going to use a calculator because I'm not that smart. So 15 times 64, that's 960. So we may need a little bit more there at the end. But by that point, maybe we'll have found some iron or something. I don't know. But my inventory, as you can see, is just completely full. So we're going to... God. I can't believe all these railroads. Okay, we're going to put... There's a railroad chest, which I made preemptively, I guess, a long time ago. We're going to put those in there. Okay, now we're going to make some powered rails. And to make those, I don't remember the exact recipe. I think it's... I mean, if we type in powered... Okay, so we just need redstone, stick, and gold. Okay, so we may have enough gold. Probably enough redstone. Oh, wow. That's way more than I need. Okay. We'll throw it on the ground for right now. We're going to make powered railroads. Is that enough? Gee, I wonder. Okay, we should be good. Now we can make everything back into its respective blocks just so that we don't have to worry about inventory space, nothing like that. And yeah, we should only have to come back like one time while building this to, you know, get some more powered rails or something. Obviously, I don't need all this wood on me. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to... throw it into a chest here. Don't need all that. We may need a little bit of logs with us. We'll just keep a stack of planks for good luck. But yeah, let me do a little bit of inventory sorting real quick here. There's not much else to put up. I don't need a bed. We'll put it in the wool area. And yeah. Okay, so now we're just going to grab as many rails as we think we need. We need redstone torches too. That's one thing I cannot forget. So we'll just take some of this. And then I wish my wood was near my rare stuff. I feel like that's always a combination I need. We'll make two stacks. How about that? Again, we just made way too much, but it's okay. We can make the blocks back really quick. Block. Boom. We're good. Okay, so we're just going to grab some rails here. I know I keep going back and forth in my inventory, but that's the last thing I have to do. Just going to climb back up. Going to grab just a bunch of rails. We have all these powered rails. We probably won't need all of them. We can actually carry everything with us, so we may not have to come back ever. We don't need those right now. I maybe should carry that bed with me because I'm going to be far away from home, dude. Oh, I'm excited. The Great Railroad. Let's get started. So I'm going to build it over here because I want my ant farm to be like, well, over here. So I'm going to build the railroad over here. I did get some coordinates down. We need to be at negative 256 for the village. Negative 256. Okay, so it's like right there. So it's fine if we get the villagers over here. We can figure it out in a bit, but I think I'm going to fill this in with dirt and then we'll build the ant farm like right here. Just horizontally. It won't be built like this way. It's going to be like a long rectangular prism. It's going to be right there. Okay. So we'll just start our railroad. See, I don't want to go through a hill to start, but you know what? It's okay. We're probably going to have to encounter quite a bit of hills. Oh, man. I'm ready for this. All right. Let's time lapse it. All right, well, we're already encountering our first problems here. As you can see, we seem to have ran into a group of trees. We also seem to have run off a cliff. It's not a good combo when you're building a railroad. You don't want to involve cliffs. There's horses this close to my house, really? Okay, I had no idea there were horses here. That's good news to me. Nice. But yeah, we ran into a cliff, so I figured I'd show you guys. The railroad seems to be going quite well. I mean, it's a pretty easy process, just takes a while, which is why it's not super fun for you guys to watch, I'm sure, just because it does take quite a bit. Of course, I'm going to go back and add the powered rails after the fact. For right now, I'm just going to focus on getting the rail itself. If anything, I could just push it myself, I'm pretty sure. Come on, move out of the way, thank you. Not trying to hurt anyone here. But yeah, okay, back to the time lapse. We may run into another problem right there with that hill, but we'll figure it out. When we get there, we'll deal with it then. Alright, well, I figure some of you may be tired of watching time lapse, so we'll do a little bit of it on camera, but this is basically what I've been doing for the past, I don't know, maybe 10-15 minutes, and we're not that far away from our base. I mean, it's definitely a big railroad, don't get me wrong, but we're not like ultra far from our base. It's going to be kind of a pain once we encounter forests, but you know what? We're going to make it work. We're going to work with what we've got here. Not that bad at all. I'll be honest with you guys. I think we'll make a tunnel when we reach like a big mountain or something like that. I think that would be actually kind of cool. I don't want the railroad to feel too cramped, so I'm trying to remove trees that I know are going to be in line with it. But if there's ones like that, that's perfectly fine. Obviously, I don't want to tear up the entire forest here, but maybe a little bit, you know, like this. You don't feel super cramped. You know what I mean? Now up here, I think this is in line with it, right? Yeah, this is in line with it. We'll break that. But there's just a ton of little stuff I've just got to do. This is fine right here. And then right there. So we can go back over here and we can start doing it now. Let's see how far we can get before we got to clear something. Because it seems like more often than not, we've gotten pretty lucky so far. No ravines, nothing like that. But of course, I've just been building over it with oak wood planks, as you've seen. And yeah, let's just see how far we can take it now. Hopefully a pretty good bit. Where I'd say we're maybe halfway there. Again, I won't record all this. I think I may quit recording in a second and just keep on trucking forward. But I really wanted to get through the flower forest and I really wanted to make a tunnel on camera. I'll probably make it look pretty eventually, but for right now, we're just going purely for utility. No aesthetics right now as far as the minecart track goes because... Actually, did we miss the flower forest? Ah, we did. Okay, so we just went right to the right of it. That's fine. Doesn't really matter. It's actually a good thing. But like through this mountain right here, I'm thinking maybe a tunnel. I don't know. What do you guys think? I almost feel like it's kind of more exciting to ride up a mountain than do a tunnel because a tunnel will also take longer and it's less fun. And since these minecarts, you know, you don't have to like power them with electricity or anything. It's okay. They can just run all the time. That's fine with me. I don't mind. I mean, obviously. How could I mind? I don't even pay the electricity bill on this world. I guess the Endermen do, probably, since they have all these weird Ender technologies. The only problem with mountains is, well, you can only go up so steep. So there's... Oh, that's the wrong tool. There's points like this where I've got to just kind of wing it a little bit because I don't know how steep this mountain is, but it looks like it's... Okay, maybe... Is this the top, though? No, but that's fine. I don't mind cutting through a mountain like this. I also don't feel like that's too cramped. But again, I'll add all of the powered rails after. I'll probably do that off camera because, man, that's going to be really boring to do. But, yeah. Give me a little bit. I'm going to keep going with this. I'll let you guys know when I feel like I'm getting close. Dang it. You know what? I'm going to show you guys this mountain because this is going to be kind of fun. And then I will do the rest of it because we're about to be very high in elevation. And I think we're close. Yes, you can see the village. It's right there. Heck yeah. So this is the part that's going to be kind of fun. We're probably going to run out of these, but that's okay. We've got to build our mountainous bridge downwards. I think what I'll end up doing is maybe some sort of support system under it. If it starts to get to where there's like too many blocks under it that are just completely blank, I would prefer for that not to happen. Of course, it's kind of impossible to prevent just because this thing is going to be massive. But like, for example, like right here, maybe I'll build like a support up. It'll also help me build the thing. But if I can just kind of do it like this, you see what I mean? And then I can get this block like right there, and then I can just kind of continue it down on that path. Hopefully that makes sense. And if I do a few of these, again, it'll make my job so much easier. And I don't mind putting a support here or something like that. That's fine with me. We can even break it up and maybe come up a little bit early and have a little bit of a flat section. I don't even know if we're going to make it up there. Oh, yeah. So you would have a little bit of a flat section there. That's fine. But yeah, let me keep making a few of these and I'll come back and show you what the bridge ends up looking like. All right. So as you can see, the railroad bridge is complete. Kind of photogenic. Obviously, it's all the same material, like just oak wood planks. So not the best build in the world. But again, this is just for utility. But it looks pretty good. It looks pretty good. That's our bridge down from the mountain. It's going to be really fun to ride. Well, maybe we'll do a ride time lapse on it because I think it'll take like 5 minutes, something ridiculous to get from one end to the other. We're almost there. You can see the top of the village smoke, maybe not from here, but I actually need to know exactly where it is because I don't want to end up like too far, you know, and like not be aware of it and just waste a bunch of rail. It looks like we'll encounter it if we just keep heading straight this direction. So I'm going to do that now. I'll have to destroy a bunch of trees, so it's going to be really boring to film, but I'm going to finish it, and then I'll show you what it looks like. All right, guys. Well, the railroad is finished, at least as far as like the actual rails go. Of course, we've got to add a few things, you know, some pretty important things, actually. We got to figure out how to get the villagers into the minecart. I'm sure we'll figure it out. But we have this part done. Now I've got to go back through and I've got to add all of these redstone torches as well as powered rails, just so obviously we can get things moving along because otherwise nothing will happen. So I'm going to go back through the entirety of this thing and do that. It's going to take quite a bit, so wish me luck. I will actually come back when it's all the way complete. I know I keep saying I'll come back when it's done. I'll actually come back when this is done because it's going to be super boring. But give me a bit. Wish me luck. And I've slept a little bit on my final railroad. Look at that. Final powered railroad. That took a while. It definitely took a while, but we're finally done with all the powered rails. I feel like I used maybe too many. I got two stacks of rail back, which is good. I have 10 powered rails, and I had to go make some more redstone torches. We still have a little bit extra. I've crafted two minecarts here. I managed to scrounge up some iron. And yeah, let's see if this bad boy works. I don't know how long it'll take to like travel the whole thing. Hold on. Let me just do this for you. I don't know what sound that is. Actually, it's fine. Let's go on a ride. Man, this is nice. And look, a free egg. Nothing. Bye, windmill. See you later. Ooh, the first big hill. Definitely have enough power trails. Doesn't even slow down a little. And I can't believe I made this. Dude, this is so awesome. I can't believe this. I guess I can. Took me forever to make, so you better believe it. Get out the way, sheep. If please don't. Ha, gotcha. Got him.
Baba booey.
I had to do it. I said I'd do it. I told Lauren I'd do it, and I did it. We got one Baba Booey in the... In, hold on. Let me do it again.
Baba Booey.
If I turn on... I could make it... If I made it clip right, it would sound like the meme one, but it sounds kind of weird. Ooh, this is a big hill coming up. Man, this is a long railroad, dude. I started at pretty much the beginning of this clip, so I'll be able to tell you exactly how long it takes. So far, it's been 2 minutes or thereabouts. Maybe like 150. I don't know. A minute and 50 seconds, something like that. Okay, and then the village is just right after this hill, which this thing is huge. We'll do a time lapse going back just to see how that looks. I feel like that would look super cool. Almost there. I want to break that. Oh, didn't do that right. Oh! That sucks. Let's get out of that. Come on. Come on. You know you want to... Okay. What have we done here? We made an oof. We made a single oof. There we go. Okay, we'll just pretend that didn't happen. We'll come flying around the corner again. And there we go. That is the entirety of this minecart track. Now, I'm going to time-lapse it going back the other way. Should be kind of exciting, potentially. I need to break this tree, though. I can already tell this is going to get in the way at some point. We'll get the villagers probably next episode back over here. Maybe we'll try a couple and see if it'll work. I just don't know. I mean, if you have two of them... Okay, so we'll put a mine... We'll put a minecart down. Do we need a boat? That's the question. Like, these are the questions I do not have the answers to. I have no earthly idea how you do this. I hope a villager can actually fit in a minecart, and I'm not remembering this wrong, because that would be... Well, that would be a shame. Now, wouldn't it? Building this giant minecart. Well, at least we can get over to the village, I guess. But I really want to make that ant farm. Okay. At the base. So in here, we'll put a little bit of extra rails if we need them. Actually, no, we're going to keep those. We don't want to put those in there. We'll put like a few, right? Well, just a couple in case something happens and we need them over here. That's fine. Put a few torches too. Okay. So I'm going to make a boat and then I'm going to try to get a villager over here. There's not really a way to lure them. I think I can make it out of this if I break this, right? I can make it down here. Okay. Get in my boat. Get in my boat, please. Yes, this is the best boat. Okay, we gotta turn her around. Okay. Let's go. Okay. Now go into the minecart. Oh no. Does it really not go up the... Okay. That's a shame. Okay, so we gotta remove this minecart. Or not this minecart. You know what I'm trying to say. We got to replace all this with just the standard dirt because for some reason, I mean, it makes sense that it's a layer below, I guess, but okay. Now I need this boat back. We got to do this kind of quick. Sure. You know what? Sure. Okay. Oh, you just went right back in there. Okay. Hop in the boat. No, hop in the boat. Yes. Okay. Turn around. Oh my God. Okay. Don't go on that right there. There we go. Now go into the minecart. Maybe we need to put the area underground that we get them into the minecart. Because I realize now we're going to have to like hit it out and then push them in. And I don't know if it's that easy. Go in the minecart. No. Go in the minecart. Okay, yeah. We're going to have to make this inside of a hole or something. Because otherwise, they're just not going to play nice. I can just predict it right now. So good thing we still have the rails with us. So So we'll have to fall into this hole right here. And then down in here will be the minecart track. We'll put like two right here. And then grab some powered rails. Go up like this. And then like this out of here. Sure. You know what? Yeah, we're going to mix it like that. That's fine. And then we're going to have, sure, that's more than okay. It works. Not gonna question it. Okay, so now we just got to get... Maybe this hole should be even bigger. I feel like that might be helpful. And then we could just try to get him down here. Only problem is we have to have a way... I may want to make this one a powered rail. We have to have a way to prevent them from just pathfinding out. So I guess when I'm doing this, I guess I should block it off. Something, you know what? We're going to try this. Maybe we'll have better luck here. Are you in your house? Okay, come on. I just like took him. All right, we're going to try it like this. And if this doesn't work, I don't know what will, dude. But we're going to try this for you. Okay, so you're in here. Can I turn you around? No. Okay. And then we're just going to... Come on. Okay, to go... No. Go in here. Yes. Go. Onwards, my friend. Onwards. He's just going, bro. He's like, see ya. Okay, that works beautifully. Okay, we're going to follow him back there. Hopefully we can catch up. Oh my goodness. This is exciting, guys. We got our first villager. Where is he? Is he going to go up the hill? Hey! He's just going. That's so awesome. I've never put another mob inside of a minecart. I don't know why. But like, that's so cool. Where are you? Oh my goodness. He's probably way down there, isn't he? I want to make sure he doesn't like fall out or like it unloads the chunks and something glitchy happens. So that's why I'm following him. Bye-bye. Okay, well, I'll meet you guys over at the other side of the railroad, or I'll just time-lapse this, actually. All right, so the railroad is almost done. Our villager made it all the way back. Oh! No, not this way! No way, dude. What are the chances of a cow sending us back the other way? Are you serious? Is there no way to stop this? Can I put a boat down or something? There we go. Okay, the boat worked. Note to self, carry boats. Let's go, brother. Come on, dude. He looks so stupid. He just has his hand. Like, I don't know why it's so funny. He just looks so stupid. Oh my goodness. I should get a screenshot though. That's a nice screenshot, dude. Okay. Now he should just go straight into the hole. I'm not going to go with him, but no. Let me get that minecart. Okay. No, did I hit him? Oh, he hates me now. Oh, dude, the first villager. It's okay. He can hate me. That's fine. We just need to... Yeah, there you go. You're stuck, dude. How's it feel, man? He's like, this isn't right. This is illegal. I'm calling my lawyer. Get out of here, dude. You're stuck forever. You're here with me. We're going to have so much fun in here. We're going to play Super Mario Party, and I'll feed you Cheetos and Gatorade. That's all you're getting, dude. Just Cheetos and Gatorade for the rest of your life. How does it feel? Okay, and then we can honestly do some parkour to get out of here. The way I like to... Man, he is not happy. We can put this here, and then to get out, we just hop like this. We'll give him a bed. How about that? You know what? We're going to give you a bed just so you'll feel a little bit better. We're not even going to put it over there, though. We're going to put your bed... Yeah. We're going to put your bed in here. Just so you don't try any funny business with us here. Come on. Let me get it in there. Okay. So, we're going to try a bed. And hopefully he can't find his way out. No way. So, you have to jump from here to the corner. And then you can get out. Okay, so I have both my minecarts. That's what I'm going to do. Maybe I'll do it in between this episode and next. I really don't know. I'd prefer to make some more minecarts, so maybe I'll do a little bit of iron mining in between this episode and the next one. But I'm very happy with our railroad. It was kind of funny near the end. I got to make sure to carry boats with me because I don't want a cow to like reverse us and send us back on a 3-minute railroad trip back. Because that's messed up, dude. That really is kind of messed up. So I'm going to go all the way back over here. I'm going to remove the boat and then we'll call it an episode. But I got to be sure to carry the boat with me whenever I'm doing this stuff because it definitely seems like a very good idea. We don't need all that stuff. We already have too many saplings of every kind. But yes, the animals around this, I'm going to have to kill them. There's that sheep standing up there, and it knows what it's capable of, so I'm just going to remove the possibility of that happening in the future. But that was genuinely funny. The villagers just look so stupid. He just, like, didn't move. His arms were crossed. He just looks like a Dorcas, and he's just riding along the railroad with me. It's just like, I don't want to be on a railroad with you. Like, honestly, you're kind of embarrassing. Okay, anyways, thank you guys seriously so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this amazing railroad episode. And yeah, I will see you guys in next week's episodes. If you're not subscribed, I highly encourage you to do so just so you don't miss any of these hardcore videos. Make sure you turn on post notifications. If you want to get notified when I live stream, that's another good way is post notifications. But if you don't want to do that, you can always join my Discord server in the top pinned comment down in the comment section below. It's the comment that's from me at the very top. And it has a link to join my Discord server. You can click on that. You'll get invited and accepted. And yeah. All right. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. And I will see you on Thursday or Friday of next week. Bye.